Alright, welcome back to the channel. I'm your host, Wisdom Cash. And today, we're going to be trying these mica powders from Arteza. Like it comes with 60 colors in a box. We're going to experiment with these. These says it's cosmetic grade, so I'm not sure if these will even work in paint, but we're definitely going to find out. So grab a cup of coffee or your favorite beverage, and let's get into it. Okay, I saw these come through my Facebook feed one day, looking for paint colors and knickknacks and pearls and what have you. And I thought it looked relatively interesting to be 60 colors. I think most of these are pearl coats, at least in the pictures, that's the way it looked. And I thought it'd be something to try. So let's go ahead and open this up. Let's see here. Got a little spoon for mixing. I guess this card kind of tells you that some of them are different sizes as far as weight. So the containers might not be full. Okay, I can live with that. Let's get a look at what's in here. Look like just regular pearls you would order online. Mixing paint, making mid coats. For those of you that don't know what a mid coat is, it's when you basically shoot a solid color like a black or even a silver, and then you want to do a pearl or like a candy on top of that. That'll be your mid coat, and then a clear coat on top of that, which is why it would be considered a mid coat. There's some interesting colors here. Very interesting. I don't know if you can see that good on camera. These pearls look really, really nice. Yeah, not bad at all. We're going to try one of these today. This one's like a rose, metallic, and pearl. Yeah, maybe we'll try this color today. What is this called? This is light plum. All right, we're going to try this today. Let's try this color. We're going to shoot it over black. We're going to use it as a mid coat. So we will use... Let's go with this balancing clear by Create Text. We'll do a little cocktail on the day. See if it'll work. This will definitely... allow that pearl to float and not sink to the bottom, which I'll explain that a little bit later. And then we're going to try that color on this kit. I picked up from Ollie's, $10. It's a great kit to just experiment with. I probably have 6 or 7 of these. So we're just going to bust this open, do some quick prep work, nothing major. And get this car into a black primer, and we'll go from there to shoot it. All right, let's get this puppy open. And let's say we're gonna do some quick prep work. Do like a quick scuff with some 600. Don't worry about the seams or mold lines and any of that stuff. I'm probably gonna end up painting this car to see if how it comes out. And then I'll probably just strip it. And save it for another experiment. I'll do an unboxing while we're here. Chrome tree, grill, chrome exhaust. Let's just see some light covers, light backings, I should say. Wheels, rings. Definitely really, really chrome. Let's see, tires. Clears and reds. Another bag. Hood. Even though I have a bunch of these kits, I've never completed one of these. This kit kind of like, it used to be a die cast that they made into a plastic kit. Could be wrong though, but it kind of has that look. Like it might have been a die cast at some time. You got your front bumper, your hood, interior pieces, dashboard. Typical stuff. The body, which is what we're going to paint today. At the bottom and like the interior. Tub is also in this bag. And engine, some suspension parts, rotors, disc brakes, steering wheel, radiator. All the good stuff you need to make something happen. Let's see, are there any decals in this kit yet? Some decals. Let's see what they are. We got a razor blade. Hold on 1 second. Okay, got a razor blade. Let's see what's in here. And we have, let's see if y'all can see these. License plates, like emblems that go on the front of the hood and possibly the trunk. I'll find that out later. But fairly simple kit. This kit's probably really easy to build. At least that's the way it looks. But this is the most important part for us because this is what we're going to paint. We can never get it out of here. Alright. I'm going to paint just this body. We'll remove that brace. I might paint the bumpers with it. Maybe if it comes out decent, maybe I will build it. Yeah, we'll see. I think these are actually chrome on the car. The molding, side moldings. I have to find out for sure. I think they're chrome. So yeah, let me get the bumpers out. Do a little prep work. I usually just sand cars with these sanding sponges, 600. I'll scuff everything up and then prime it. And then on that primer, I'll sand it with like 800 or 1,000. And then I'll go ahead and paint it. That's generally how I do it. Haven't had a whole lot of problems with it as far as scratches showing or anything of that nature. I know some people will paint over 1,000 scratches or 1,200 grit scratches. But you can because these are models. As long as the paint actually is able to mechanically adhere, usually it'll be fine. If I'm going to do like a two-tone, like racing stripes or something, then I'll usually just shoot over 800 at the finest grit. Because I want that paint to be able to bite enough where I can actually mask it, and pull a mask off and put mask back on. You know, if I need to several times and everything still stick. So, I'll shut you off and I'll prep this up and I'll be right back. Okay, basic stuff, nothing fancy. Let's get some black primer on this and move on to the bumpers. Alright, we're in the booth. Usually when I'm about to paint something or prime something, I'll take a tack cloth and then I'll just actually wipe down the booth. Just to get some of the bigger dirt that's in here out. I'm not a painter that's afraid to get a little dirt in the paint. I don't have a problem with sanding and buffing the stuff out if need be. Usually not that big of a deal. Unless it's something really, really big. And then usually I'll take a separate tack cloth and I'll actually tack off the car after I blow everything off. And then I'll just go ahead and shoot it. That's basically the strategy I use in most of my paint jobs. Fresh tack rag. Also, a lot of my paint jobs, when I'm painting something that I know I'm going to build for specific reasons, I'll actually back mask everything inside, which I'll do another video on that another time, because this is primarily just to test out this paint. But back masking actually helps keep a lot of the dirt out of the paint job as well, especially if you're painting. And you don't really have a booth or like a cardboard box, but it tends to just attract a lot of dust. Definitely helps you out a lot. Alright, spilled a little primer trying to pour this out. Didn't have this cap on tight. Let's try this one more time. Primer in here. Let's see what we can make happen. This is a water-based primer. It goes on pretty thick and sometimes will kind of clog up on you here and there, but it sands beautifully. And you actually can reduce this primer a little bit if you want to make it more like a sealer versus a primer. And if you don't know the difference between sealer and primer, I'll do a video on that as well. One of the biggest differences when you seal something, generally you don't do any sanding afterwards. On a primer, you're trying to get a little bit of build. And then you sand it nice and smooth, and then you just paint it. So a sealer typically can be shot so smooth, you don't need to sand it. It's a little bit thinner than a primer. There was a time when I used to just actually seal almost every car I painted because they were all just one color. And I would just, you know, scuff the car up, seal it, and shoot it. And they came off fine majority of the time. Just cutting a few pieces of lint. No biggie. Notice that spatter, that's because it's really a thick primer. I could shoot this out of a bigger tip on the airbrush, actually just don't have one right now. The one I had is actually broken. I need to order another one. It would allow this to fall a lot better. It's not going to really affect the paint job, however. We're still going to sand this primer, get all the dirt out before we even start basing it, putting any color on it at all. Because we're not going to shoot the pearl over black primer. We're still going to paint this car black. And we're going to shoot that mica powder over black. So I just need to get paint on this thing enough to sand. Although it looks fairly crazy because it's water based, after it flash off, everything will be nice and even. Alright, primer has dried. We hit it with some 1000 right quick. I didn't have any 800 on hand, so 1000 just have to do. We're gonna shoot this with some basic black and some create text. You can catch that in the camera. Create text, opaque black. Reduce a little bit of 411. And we'll just see how it comes out. One of the advantages to water base is that you can pretty much shoot two or three coats back to back and then let the whole thing flash off and dry good. Do any nibbing out you need to do if it's a solid color, and basically blow a little color in and you can move on to your next step, which could either be clear or mid coat or anything else. Just don't pile it on too heavy. As the heavier you pile it on, it'll take a little longer to dry. And you gotta understand that acrylic or water-based paints generally dries with moving air. So if you have a small fan in the area, if you just turn that fan on and blow it across your model or whatever you're painting, it'll actually dry a little bit faster. And that's basically it for the black. We'll let that flash off. Come back with a mid coat of this Arteza light plum. Gonna try this, see what it looks like. Stay tuned. Alright, while that black is drying, we're gonna mix up some mid coat. There's no exact science to what I'm about to do here because this is just an experiment. But if you're into making custom colors on a regular basis, you want to record how much of each ingredient you use. In this scenario, I'm just going to use some balancing clear, a splash of reducer, and then I'm going to do a couple scoops of this and just see how it looks as I mix it up. I'm going to start with an ounce of balancing clear so I have more enough paint. If I decide I like the color, I can paint the hood, I can paint the bumpers, and I can just count how many coats I use, the air pressure, and you know, etc. And it should yield a pretty good match. If for any reason something doesn't match, I can always just do a spot blend repair and then re-clear the whole car. Really not that big of a deal. And that's another video I'll probably make on how to blend when you do paint parts separate and they don't match. You need to go back in and fix that. But that's another video for another day. At any rate, let's get back to this madness. We're going to do just an ounce of this. If you guys don't really be able to see on camera, but I can see it through the cup. We're going to take this. And let's take our little scooper. And we'll just start off with, if I can get the scoop here. It normally doesn't take a lot of pearl to mix and activate this stuff. Not generally. Takes very little. Grab a paint stick. I'd imagine this will end up being like a magenta color. Not 100% sure. So far it's like really, really pink. But because this is a mica, it's called a mica powder, to me it's just a pearl. What it looks like over black might be totally different than what it looks like in the raw mix. And like I said, if you were doing this to make a permanent color, either make a whole lot of it or measure everything up so that you can make this color again if you wanted to. I'm really big on custom colors. I'll make stuff one time, and when it's gone, it's just gone. And make something else. The possibilities are endless with paint just in general. Pearls, flakes, candies. You can pretty much make anything. You're not really limited to just, you know, a certain amount of colors. Now looking at this, I don't know if you really catch it on the camera. Probably can't see the pearls. Looks more like a liquid form of what's actually in this jar. Might be a little bit too much pearl. We're gonna find out though. Try to mix it up really, really well. Break down all the powder. And then sort of flow through the airbrush a little bit better as well. And see, this has a consistency that's a little thicker than milk. So you're going to want to reduce it some for sure. And I usually go a little reducer at a time, stir it up, take a look at it. See if it's getting a little bit better. That's a little better. Let me add a little bit more. A little more mixing. Yeah, that's about 2% milk consistency. This ought to flow out very nice through the airbrush. Very nice. Alright. Pack this up. We'll get that cleaned. Set this aside. Yeah, I think this will work. All right, we get this loaded in the airbrush. Let's go back to the booth and let's paint. All right, we're back in the booth. Got our mid coat mixed up in our airbrush. We're going to just blow this off lightly and then we're going to start spraying. Start off with two coats. Let that flash. We'll come back with another two coats. We'll put some clear on this and see what kind of effect it has on black. You're wondering why I chose black, because I really wanted to see if it would have an effect on a dark color. I can almost guarantee you this will work on a light color, white, cream. It would probably work spectacular. But I think this is going to have a really good look in the light once it's cleared. So that's one coat down. We'll do another coat, which I won't film. And then we'll come back with some clear. Alright, while that mid coat is flashing off, which won't take long at all, probably like 5-10 minutes, we're gonna mix up some clear coat. We're using a 4-to-1 clear. This is USC Universal Urethane Clear Coat. I'm using a slow activator so that it will flow out a little bit better. Personally, I think for models, a European clear seems to work a little bit better. It's a little bit thinner. You don't need to really reduce it at all. It flows out really good. But any 2K clear can get you a really good shine. I think with a European clear, it's just easier to work with. And I'll do a video on one of those as well. Because I actually like to use a clear coat. I believe it's Green Tech 211. And it flows out very nice and lays out pretty much like glass. This stuff is decent. It's not bad at all, but there are some better clears than this. But this is what I happen to have here. I haven't used this in a while. Hope it's good. We're going to find out. So we'll mix some up and we'll be right back in the booth. All right, we're back in the booth. About to lay this clear coat down. If you're spraying any type of paint, clear coat with hardener in there, make sure you're wearing a mask, minimum. Very important to wear a mask. This stuff is pretty poisonous. And if you're a guy like myself, been painting real cars for a lot of years, you need to wear a mask. Not like the olden days where guys never wore a mask. Nowadays, you need to wear a mask. And if you're painting models, definitely have a mask on, at least one glove. And protect yourself so you can paint more stuff. I'm going to put my mask on, and I'm going to get the paint. Alright, one of those trims to go out before I take my mask off. As you can see, that light plum over black makes like a blue metallic looking color. Just the first coat of clear. Then we'll go another coat of clear for sure. And then we'll probably go with a third coat of clear with a little bit of reducer so it can flow out and give it a little bit more shine. And it should end up being glass or pretty close to it. So, stay tuned. We'll be back with the next coat of clear. Alright, we're back. About to put on the second coat of clear. Let me get my mask on and get the spraying. Alright, and that's our second coat of clear. Now we're going to take the clear coat we have left, add some reducer to it, create somewhat of a flow coat, and that should be it. Should be a done deal. Final coat of clear, here we go. Alright, you can see as I was spraying that last coat of clear, something got caught up in the airbrush, so it wasn't spraying like it should. Just trying to compensate for that by putting on a few more coats. And then once I got whatever in there out, it started spraying a lot better. Gave me an opportunity to put like two really good full wet coats on, maybe two and a half. And you have to get it enough clear on there so it will flow out. Typically, I would not put this much clear on a car because I have a problem with the airbrush. I want to put a few extra coats of clear. When the clear is spraying out like it should, Usually three coats is all you need for spraying really, really strong. The clear I'm using is relatively old, probably years old. But it looks like it still got the job done. And probably could have got a little bit better job if I had strained that clear coat. But the car overall looks good. It'll buff out to a nice shine. It's definitely more like a bluish color with that light plum over black. Worked out quite well, actually. So we'll polish it up. Let it sit for a few days, maybe even a few weeks. We'll get back to it, do a video on polishing, wet sanding. We'll do the roof and the trunk. Maybe the sides a little bit. We'll see how it looks when it's get done flashing and drying off. But that's pretty much it. We'll put this car on the turntable so you guys can look at it at the end of the video. And this is pretty much it. We'll cut to that, and I'll see you guys on the next one. Like, comment, subscribe to help grow the channel. And we'll do another video next week at the latest. All right, I'm out.